Welcome back for another VeChain price prediction analysis. And at the time of this recording, VeChain continues to hold above the 20-day MA here on the 4-hour chart, which is now acting as support for us to continue gearing up. We have also continued to hold above support at around the $0.0179 mark, which is also acting as support for us to continue gearing up to our next key area of resistance at around the $0.02 mark. And a break above the $0.02 mark with the retest, then we can continue anticipating for higher prices here on the VeChain chart and maybe see a break above the $0.02263 mark. VeChain continues to obey the ETH2F structures also, and zooming out on the charts, you can see that VeChain gave us a bear market low at around the $0.013 mark before we saw this massive push to the upper side in a 5-wave structure, giving us a high above the $0.021 mark, completing the formation of this wave 1 to the upper side. And after seeing the formation of that first wave, we started a corrective structure in the formation of this wave 2 in a move that gave us a bit of a pullback into the minimum target areas highlighted on the charts using this blue target area. And at some point we saw a reaction of these in what could be the start of an impulse in the formation of these wave 3 to the upper side. And because of the impulsiveness in the formation of that wave 3, I'm also expecting to see VeChain give us another complete 5-wave structure to the upside. And here on the charts, you can see that we have now seen the formation of this wave 1, seen a bit of a pullback in the formation of this wave 2. Before this week, we saw this massive push to the upper side in the formation of this wave 3 in a move that has now given us a break above key areas of resistances. And the minimum target areas for the third wave can be given using the trend-based Fibonacci, connecting it from the low of the first wave to the high of that wave 1, then dragging the Fibs to the low of the second wave. And that gives me a minimum target area at the Fib level 1.618, and that is at around the $0.02213 mark. And that is the minimum that we can expect that third wave to the upper side to do. So in the next coming hours, in case we continue holding above support and see another push to the upper side, I'm expecting VeChain to give us a high at around the $0.02213 mark before we can expect a pullback in the formation of this wave 4 and then continue gearing up in the formation of this wave 5 to the upper side. So that is what I'm keeping my eyes on the short term here on the VeChain chart. And we also need to have in mind that we can see a pullback and maybe lose support here on the charts. And in case such a movement plays out, then we need to be super careful. And using the Fibonacci's, we need to have areas that VeChain needs to continue holding, assuming that we don't continue gearing up from the prices that we are trading within. And using the Fibonacci's, connecting it from the lows on the 18th of October to that high, we need to continue holding above the Fib level 0.78, and that is at around the $0.01671 mark. And as long as you hold above that, we can expect higher. But if we lose that, then there are chances that we are going to see one more pullback into this blue target area, get one more new low before we can continue getting impulsive in the formation of that wave 3 to the upper side. So that is what I'm keeping my eyes on the short term and also on the long term. And I hope that video was of much help to you. And if it was, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and also check out the channel membership.